Fantasy Philosophers is brought to you by fantasy-info.com.
Alex Smith had himself a little bit of a mini resurgence as he had 18 touchdowns and over 2,300 yards passing in his 10 starts last season. This year, Alex Smith is the standalone starter for the San Francisco 49ers, and he received some nice upgrades in the offseason at the draft when the team drafted Mike Iupati, the big left guard, and they also drafted Anthony Davis for right tackle. These pickups should help Smith have more time, as in these two areas of the offensive line, this team really struggled, and even though these guys are rookies, the odds are they're probably going to play more productive than what the team gave out last season. Beyond those positives, we're seeing good things from Alex Smith, as Vernon Davis noted in OTAs this year that Alex is starting to take on more of a leadership role. He's being a lot more vocal. He's taking charge of this offense, and these are the things that you like to see. I believe Alex is, in his sixth season now as a quarterback in the NFL. He's been through a lot in his career. Obviously, the 49ers really didn't give him much to work with throughout the first 4 years of his career. To see him have these tools around him now is encouraging. To have an offensive line that's actually in a year or two could be pretty darn good. He's got still a good running game that defenses have to respect, and he's also got really probably the best pass-catching tight end maybe outside of Antonio Gates right now in the league with Vernon Davis. Michael Crabtree looks to be a high riser that's moving up with his talent and his ability, so now it looks like he's probably got a resemblance of a number one receiver. These are all good things for Alex. He also has the fourth easiest schedule to pass against this year. And I know there's a lot of fantasy owners, maybe you're not that high on schedules, you know, as far as strength of schedule, but hey, having the fourth easiest schedule and playing in the NFC West and playing the AFC West this year isn't going to hurt him. So with Alex Smith, I don't think he's a guy that you should be drafting on fantasy day, but if the guy that you drafted that you had your hopes on, if he's not getting it done for you, got injured or whatnot, and Alex is getting it done, then give this guy a look, because he's got tools now around him. Again, 18 touchdowns in his 10 starts last year. These are things that you want to consider. And I should say 18 touchdowns in 11 games overall. I think he had one game where he threw three touchdowns against the Texans when he didn't start. But still, those are good numbers. And so we need to see him continue that progression. He's not going to be a fantasy juggernaut or anything else, but he might help you through a bye week and maybe a little rough patch when a guy's injured or, you know, downtrodden, maybe like a Jay Cutler's in a bad funk. So keep that in mind, and Alex should be able to help you in a pinch.
For more fantasy football information, go to fantasy-info.com and sign up for our free e-newsletter. Good luck in your 2010 Fantasy Football League. As an added bonus, the Fantasy Info guys will include their 5 secret tips for success in fantasy.